What is up, everyone? This is GingaDude15 here in Soul Studios with KyleBrennan4544. We are playing Manual Samuel today. This is a co-op. How'd you say it? Was it
co-op? It's a co-op game.
Co-op game. I didn't know if it was like a special game. What this is like I have control of half the body. He has control of half the body, and we got to go. We just got to survive, right? I've never played. He has. I don't know what I'm doing. So this is probably going to be really, really brutal. Coop. So wait, am I this side? Okay, I'm this side.
We can choose.
Oh, okay.
We can choose what we get to control.
Oh, shit. Okay. Okay. So the head. What do you do with the head? Like, you gotta keep it upright or what?
Yeah.
Okay. Okay.
And turning is you turn your body left and right. The spine, occasionally you'll fall over, and the guy who controls the spine can put you right back up. Left leg and right leg is obviously walking.
Right.
Blinking, you'll need to blink because, yeah. Breathing and breathing out is very, very important. Left arm and right arm is just, they're occasional things. Occasionally you'll see something you want to pick up and you have to click it.
Okay.
And we can change what each other wants. Like one person can control breathing and breathing, or
breathing in and out.
One person can control left arm, left leg, right leg.
So one person controls both. I kind of want to do like the whole left side. You know what I mean? Like,
you want to do left side?
Yeah, like I'm okay with that. Left with these two.
Okay. Spine, you have control of spine, I have control of turnaround and head. You control of blinking, I have control of breathing in, and you control of breathing out.
And B. Okay, so yeah, I can actually click all my buttons all at once if I need to.
So you're gonna go through.
Do you know the same smells? You want to leave it like this or you want to change something?
I mean, last time I played this, someone controlled both breathing in and breathing out because it seemed very
easy to.
Yeah, it was very easy for a person to control breathing.
Okay, what's the other one I got? Hey, okay, do you want to do breathing in and breathing out, or do you want to do blinking? Because I feel like worrying about both of those.
But you want me to do breathing in and breathing out? Because I can do that. I think that's what I had last time I played.
You
want to
do that?
Sure.
Okay. I thought having breathing in, breathing out, and blinking all together would be hard.
Yeah.
So that's why I thought of separating. Okay, yeah. Oh, it's not right.
I think you have to. I go press down.
Yeah, okay, there it goes. Okay. Whoops, no. You're player two. Okay. Okay. I only have four things. Are you sure you don't want me to take something else?
You can take the, you can take turn.
Take turn. Whoops. Okay. That's this stick, right?
Mm-hmm.
Three number that stick.
Turning is just to turn left or right. It changes. It's a side scrolling game, so it changes.
So okay. Go left or right. Okay. Are we ready?
Yeah.
Whew. I'm so nervous.
a lot of different controls.
Okay, story mode. I'm so excited!
Our story begins in the middle of the 40s, when a hopeful young soldier called Sam... we're not doing that? Our story begins in the middle of last Tuesday, where a hopeless young freeloader called Sam is sipping a fancy cup of coffee with a name nobody can pronounce. Sam was born with a silver spoon in his mouth. But not the actual spoon that he has in his mouth now. That is a different spoon. But a figurative spoon that represents all the wealth and attention that he has been receiving from his parents.
Yes.
And their butlers. And their butlers' parents. You're a douche, aren't you, Sam? Blink twice if yes. He can't hear me. This is Sam's girlfriend, also not being heard by Sam. She's mad at Sam for his lack of responsibility produced by his large wealth. She also mentions the fact that Sam has forgotten her birthday for the third year in a row. Sam's girlfriend is upset. As with most rich and famous brats, Sam does not pick up on that. Instead, he decides to lay this gem.
Things just work out for me, baby. I can't just run around and do stuff. I'd end up with a limp spine
then,
or something.
Sam's girlfriend does something she should have done a long time ago.
Damn.
Sam is laying unconscious on the floor. He gathers his strength and makes an effort to get up.
Is this... Okay.
Then he makes another effort to stand up straight. Sam is hit in the head so hard, he has to remind himself how to walk. He takes a right step. Then he takes a left step. Good job, Sam! You're very good at existing.
Very good at existing. Oh. Huh?
How dare you startle my child?
An overprotective mother hurls a cup of coffee in Sam's face. He has to blink rapidly to regain his vision.
Say something, Harold.
Oh.
How is our
son? I was waiting for her to stop talking.
Fend for himself.
I thought he was going to become an actor.
Oh, what's the difference?
It's your turn to walk.
Oh.
Sam remembers the one thing he's good at. Paying for stuff. So he turns around to pay for his beverage.
Other one.
Whoops. I was like...
Sam pays the guy 500 euros, barely covering the coffee.
Thanks for the tip, douchebag.
Sam decides to hurl another 500 at the guy. Not such a douchebag after all.
No.
You keep doing it. I think you get a teammate to do it.
Oh, you do?
Yeah.
Sam is hurling stacks of 500s left and right. He has no perception of money. Sam is about to spend his whole weekly allowance on tipping a barista named Tony. He really was hit hard in the head.
Holy feces. I'll just start my own coffee shop.
Yay.
Once again, Sam makes someone quit their job by tipping them too much.
Oh, I got my achievement.
He's
my
right.
Sam spends a decade making his way out the door, which is pretty good for a guy with a major concussion. As Sam waggles outside, he sees his girlfriend on the other side of the road. Sam pulls himself together and rushes towards his soon-to-be ex-girlfriend. This is when a septic tank truck approaches Sam with an average speed of 90 kilometers per hour. The impact renders him 8 types of dead.
They caught me off guard. Right? It wasn't. I like to shoot. That was a good one. It's a good achievement. Feces happens. Let's go. I like it. I'm so easily entertained.
I believe we're taking the room to hell.
I believe so. Just like,
happens to be a bus stop.
I was thinking, like, bus stops are like, I'm assuming they're like people that more than one game.
Yeah.
Yes, we're single. That's great. He's just slide that in there so you can get a girlfriend off this game. It's funny. Desperate as fuck.
Who knew a bottle to the face would result in such a terrible fate for Sam? But a bottle won't be the only thing that will meet Sam's face today. There's also the ground in hell. Sam does not like being dead a single bit. He also hates the eerie feeling of not having any cash on him. Then he finds 7 glowing notes in his pocket. That makes him feel reasonably better. He checks out that horrible sound he's hearing. Not the horrible sound of the screaming souls around him. The other horribly irritating sound.
Oh, that's what we're going to.
The source of the sound is none other than obliteration and oblivion, extermination and extinction, the end, decease and demise, the Grim Reaper, death. He's trying to do a kickflip on a skateboard and is dressed like a douchebag for some reason. In his coarse, horrifying voice, he lays this on Sam.
Yo, yo, yo! You must be Sam from the info I was provided.
Then he takes a second look at Sam, and his eye sockets widen.
Holy feces, dude! Your soul be like a diamond! Let me cut you a deal that we can seal. For reals? Aight, man, it decided.
The notes in Sam's pocket are something called a shred of life. Every soul has at least one, and it is the biggest unit in Hell's currency. Followed by quality of life, school of life, sound of life, meaning of life, and thug life.
If you give me your shreds, I'll resurrect your face and get you out of hell on one condition. You'll have to survive 24 hours with a handicap I choose under my supervision, bro.
Sam decides to check out the rest of hell before doing any deals with supernatural beings.
Why, hello there, dear sir. Let's see if we can find a job for you. You get to be... ooh, a plumber. That'll be all your shreds, dear sir.
All right, that sounds fair. Yes.
Sam notices that the souls that get into hell are forced to get a job and become functioning souls of society. For most people, this is okay, but for Sam, it's horrifying. He hurls his shreds at death like he's never hurled piles of money before.
Why, hello there, dear sir. Let's see if we can find a job.
He keeps the last shred for the next time he meets the gatekeeper of hell, whenever that's going to be.
Hehe. Aight, bro. I only get to do these deals annually. But if you really want to live in biz, you have to do it manually. Also, I will stop speaking in rhymes now.
Psh. Psh. He just slides. Oh my god. I do believe this begins our journey of living manually. Complete level 2.
Sam has just traveled through time, space, and logic, and finds himself fully alive, and more importantly, rich again. His joy is only dimmed by the fact that he can't move at all. This is when he shows up. Death.
Yo, yo, yo! Oh, yeah, you look horrible. I mean, you look great, bro. You be okay? Can you hear me? Blink twice if yes. Oh, cool. You'll be alive. Everything be fine. Aight, so this here be the dealing biz. All your body functions be manual, so you kind of have to do stuff on purpose. You'll be turning kind of blue. Might want to consider breathing.
and you be blinking and breathing, that be bitching.
That be bitching.
All right. Go survive for a day, and I'll let you live normally for the rest of your life. If you somehow die within the next 24 hours, you'll go to hell and I'll keep your shreds forever. I'll be over there doing kickflips if and you need me.
Once again, Sam has to make an effort to get up. This time, he has to focus on his spine. And once again, he has to remind himself how to walk.
Oh, by the way, dude, you be getting late for work.
Sam does something that resembles walking towards the bathroom.
Gonna do a kickflip now.
Well, let me yet.
Friggin' skateboard. Hi, let's see.
I have no clue where the hell the bathroom is, so we're just walking right now. Found it.
Sam holds on to that toothbrush like his life depends on it.
Right.
Sam has some trouble with his posture and has to focus on his spine.
He's here. Press Y to clean the teeth. I didn't know how to tap it.
With clean teeth, Sam is ready to smile. He won't for at least 24 hours. Sam has some trouble with his posture and has to focus on his spine.
I think you have to press your other. You have to press your leg to get back up. Yeah.
Oh, okay.
You press it. There you go. What
was that? Sam tries to take a leak.
Oh, we're, okay.
Hey, dude, have you seen my... Oh.
Sam's vision is blurrier than a Norwegian teenager at a wedding. He decides to blink. Sam takes a leak. One empty bladder later, Sam moves on. Sam tries to take a shower. He looks like a mantis that's trying to explain to someone how a bicycle works.
Bye. Oh, we need to keep cleaning. You haven't washed your head yet.
Oh.
Sam is clean as a whistle.
I didn't notice the light putting up there. It's fun to breathe.
Sam has some trouble with his posture. He has to focus on his spine.
It is. Oh, here's again. Sorry, we got this.
Clean and empty. Sam decides to find some clues.
Breathe.
Freaking skateboard. Hi, let's see.
Your turn.
Yeah! Yeah! Hi, let's see.
Yeah, we got it. Now. We got it.
Clever boy.
Breathe.
Sam enters his wardrobe. What will he wear today? He picks a pair of blue jeans. The ugly ones. Sam successfully puts on his pants. Feeling more accomplished than ever, he proceeds to find a jacket. Only the best one will do. Blink, Sam, blink! Fully clothed, Sam is ready for the day. P.S. He's not.
Good try. Let's put us together. Her shoes?
Oh, okay.
Your spine, Sam. It matters. He puts so on slick. His shoes, living the dream
really
of having shoes
yeah,
on.
Yeah, just oh, no, I just went back in, my bad. Okay, here we go. Oh.
Sam walks down the stairs with great precision. Sam decides to
hurl
down the stairs, apparently too used to hurling money around.
Back in. Oh, whoops, your turn. This is hard, man.
Flappy Rooster is Sam's favorite Try. Game. Try. He has no time for playing with a Flappy Rooster right now, though.
Oh. Sucks. I want to play Flappy Rooster. I'll flap that rooster. Oh, whoops.
Following this story at this time, and gang wars are still an escalating problem at Bridge Street, where the police are struggling to regain control. Commuters are advised to...
Hey, Lucy, I'm home.
Oh, hey, dude. Still alive, huh?
I realized like, we could still die while he was watching TV. We almost died right there. He fell over and I was not...
There is a note saying, sent over a maid to make you breakfast. Don't breathe in while chewing. Love, Mom.
Wait, doesn't make sense. You're pressed Y. Alright, I gotta feed myself.
Sam spills most of his food on the floor. No one is surprised.
It's all good. Yeah, we got this.
Sam decides to try his luck on some coffee drinking. Sam's coffee is so hot, he blows on it before taking a sip.
Got it.
With some coffee in his system, Sam finds it easier to exist.
Me every day.
Finally makes it out the front door. Beaten, terrified, stupid.
Yay. Watch yourself.
Dude, I am totally gonna kickflip over your car. Oh, dang. Oh, man, that hurt. Dude, it was like that when I got there. You might want to get that hood fixed. It be loose. Yeah, I'll just get in the car.
You know, this game is meant to play single player run. Do you believe you can taking control of all this? No.
Hey, dude. I turned your automatic gearbox into a manual one for the fun. That'd be ironic or what?
At this point, Sam notices that Dev isn't really a nice guy.
I guess I should teach you how to drive a stick, huh? Aight, so, when starting the car, you want to press down the clutch pedal.
Nobody has clutched anything for years.
We're going to drive their eyes closed. Okay,
now,
let's clutch.
While you have the clutch down, press the gas pedal. As you let go of the clutch, the car will start moving them bits. Good job, dude. You ain't as useless as you look, know what I mean? Now, to stop, you gotta move your right foot to the brake pedal.
Left for us, he means.
And obviously, press it down. Give stopping a go, dude.
Breathe.
Nice. Now, start driving again, like I showed you.
Get your clutch, please.
And obviously, you turn left and right with your arms.
Which is fine. That's your head.
If you want to drive faster, you gotta use the stick, baby. To upshift, you press down the clutch and then yank the stick.
Okay. Clutch and then press that, so whenever you're
Obviously, you can't turn left when your hand be on the stick. So to turn left, you have to move your hand back to the steering wheel, y'all.
We get it, we get it. We got this.
And so Sam and the Lord of Damnation are on their merry way towards a new adventure.
Everyone shift together.
Cozy.
Dude, there be an old lady on the road. Yo, go right. We almost killed that lady. She ain't due for another... a few hours. Listen, if you kill somebody before their time because I messed up your motoring skills, I will be in deep feces, okay?
Oh, shit.
Keep your eyes on the road. If you almost kill someone, I'll stop the car, yo. But then...
Chris,
you'll have to start it all over again with the clutching bit.
Not triggering.
Right? We'd be good to go.
Here we go.
Anyway, dude, you're probably wondering why all this biz be happening to me. To tell you the truth, bro, it be all part of pure... Go left, dude. Holy feces. Anyway, to tell you the truth, bro, it be all part of bureaucratic bull feces. The shreds of life you give to those holy feces. Anyway, the shreds of life you give to those gatekeepers to get into hell, yeah, they'd be distributed between the bank of hell left. Close one. As I was saying, the shreds of life you give to those gatekeepers to get into hell, yeah, they'd be distributed left. Close one. As I was saying. The shreds of life you give to those gatekeepers to get into hell, yeah, they'd be distributed between the bank of hell and Satan. Oh, yeah, dude. What be that gray cloud in the middle of the road? Oh, feces! That'd be a whole school of old ladies! Get ready!
I stopped. Okay. Empty clutch. Here we go.
Yo, go left. Ah! Right. Ah! Left. Ah! Right. Ah! Left. Ah! What be up with all those old ladies today, bro? Hey, Sam. You're never gonna make it to work on time with all these grannies everywhere, dude. What do you say we take a shortcut? Yo,
And so Sam drives the car to the place. He has never been.
I don't understand how that happened. I clicked LT, but it went like RV.
Oh, dude. I hope it be safe here. Hope there be no, say, crazy gang members here or nothing.
Time to define some now. You ready?
No, really, though. Where be the crazy gang members? Oh, crazy gang members. Oh, excuse me. You be a crazy gang member?
Breathe.
Don't you worry. I know where the crazy gang members be.
To Death's surprise and Sam's relief, the gang members are lying dead on the ground. This is when Death notices a distinct silhouette in the distance.
What be the deal, bro? Why be there? Oh,
the silhouette is contention and envy, bloodshed and hostility, strife and strike, struggle, battle, war. She is neither wearing dumb clothes nor doing kickflips. She is just standing there after a job well done.
Oh, holy feces, it be her! I'll be my breath. Be cool. Be cool. Okay, just don't be yourself. Hey, War, how it be going, babe? Wanna hitch a ride in these sweet wheels? Oh, holy feces, here she comes. Hey, girl, where to?
Just shut up and take me to the metro. Aren't you supposed to, like, reap a bunch of people, you knucklehead?
I was.
Oh, shit.
I got bored, so now I hang out with my buddy Sammy here. Ain't it right, Sammy?
Stop here. Stop.
Ah,
Okay, let's go.
Let's take care of that.
So instead of guiding endless amounts of confused souls to the afterlife, you waste time with this dumb, ugly mortal. Stop here.
It should be.
Okay, let's go.
Bitch, you're trying to get on my nerves.
You want a cigarette?
You're so annoying. You know I'm trying to quit. Fine, give me one.
I hate you.
Go right here. Stop here.
Wait.
Okay, we can go.
Hey, guess what? I totally landed a kickflip today.
Take a left. What's wrong with you? Take the next turn. Stop here. Okay, we can go. Wow, you really landed a kickflip? That's kind of hot.
Yeah, or... well, I almost landed a kickflip.
You know, Famine can do a frontside kickflip.
Such a show.
Stop here. Okay, we can go.
Gosh damn it. It's like used to. Yeah,
grandma's be back.
No! Okay. Yeah.
Yo, right. Left. Right. Left. Yo. Oh, I never be getting used to those grannies.
Stop here. This is where I get off.
Hi, babe. I'll see you around.
Whatever.
We're doing all right. We're doing all right. Not bad. We didn't kill nobody.
Driving a car would be harder.
What you be looking at?
The road?
Yes.
Oh, snap! You be getting late for work, bro. Step on it as hard as you can if we gonna make it. Go, go, go! Yo, faster, faster! Yo, faster, faster! Faster, dude. Get up to fifth gear. Almost fast enough, dude. Step on it. Oh, feces. Stop. Stop.
We crashed.
Oh, fudge.
Feces. Did we kill somebody? Oh, please let it just be a rock or a hipster or something.
Sam goes out the door to see what happens. He only has to follow Death's crying voice.
This guy wasn't due. He wasn't due. What be I gonna do? Hey, wait a minute. Hey, Sam, can I borrow your last shred of life? Blink twice if yes.
I guess we're doing this.
Don't do it, Sam. Don't blink again.
You won't die if you don't blink. You'll just get really blurry.
Fine.
Right. Yo, 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 let's do a deal that we can steal, yada, yada, yada. Slap your salmon 57 times in 24 hours or you'll be dead forever. Now, get out of here.
Holy crap.
I just had to. Anyway, let's get out of here.
Slap your salmon 57 times. That's a lot. It is. Same drives.
It's another busy day in RoboCorp Inc., where they produce automatic robots for fun, convenience, and most importantly, safety. Finally, Sam makes it to work, and only by having the most terrifying morning of his life. He waggles towards the entrance, still shaky after the events of his trip.
Yeah, boy.
I blew my nose off in a laser accident. They gave me a robot nose.
Ah, RoboCorp's proudest and newest invention, the MaidBot. It is rumored to have over 3,000 functions, including pest control, rest control, and guest control. And it can make you a nice cup of coffee. Yes, Sam, do the splits. They'll respect you more. For the 7 billionth time, Sam has lost the key card to his office and has to request a new one from reception. Sam focuses all his brain energy on trying to speak well-formulated sentences.
Hello, Mr. Samuel. How can I help you?
I...
Very good, sir. Was there anything else?
God damn, that's hard. Breathe.
I didn't really catch that, sir.
Sam tries again. He needs his key card.
Eventually it'll get bigger.
Okay. I didn't really catch that, sir.
Sam tries again. He needs his key card. You are a wordsmith, Sam.
Yeah.
Of course, sir. Try not to lose it again.
That's funny. I promise. I'm bad at losing shit.
Sam,
I have to fucking hold it this whole time.
Heads for his office.
Shit.
We've seen Sam do weirder things. The elevator is occupied. Sam has no time for waiting.
And then he meets his old nemesis. Stairs.
That was my fault. I was wondering whose foot it was.
The real challenge.
Yeah. Okay. Me, you, me, 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 me.
Sam goes in the third door to his office area.
Yeah, it is a dangerous job, but the health benefits are awesome, dude! I blew off my leg in a laser accident, and they gave me a new one right away!
This is Ingrid, Sam's secretary. Since Sam never gets any calls or does any actual work, Ingrid has a level 80 warrior in every game ever made.
Wait, did I even go in there? Probably, but I want to see what she says. Your step. You can drop it for right now. It's your step.
And I got this one after my 16th laser accident. Honestly, I can barely feel pain anymore.
Here's something right
here. Sam's office. A waste of space, according to everyone ever. Sam doesn't do much at work, simply because his father doesn't let him. According to Samuel Sr., he only has to
Show up, shut up, and not mess up.
This gives Sam plenty of time to sharpen his skills on his favorite game, Flappy Rooster. Yes, he has one here too. Sam decides to try and beat his record of 10,000 points.
Oh, I love the picture, man.
That's sexy.
Someone knocks on Sam's door. It is Ingrid.
Mr. Samuel. Mr. Welfenberg wants to speak with you.
Also known as Samuel Sr. Sam's dad.
He seems kind of angry. Take the elevator to his office.
Here's leaving already.
The soothing elevator music sets the mood for productivity and not asking questions.
Asking more questions.
All of Sam's interactions with his old man have lately been reduced to short meetings in his office.
So if that's like buzz me.
This is Samuel Sr. He owns RoboCorp Inc.
Mm-hmm.
And he is tired of the fact that Sam is always late to work. Sam is keeping the morale of his company down, and it is time for him to work for his money.
No more fancy offices.
You are starting at the bottom. Today, you start as a Lefidium inserter in the storage room. Go down to the basement and get to work.
Sam has done weirder things to impress his dad.
Oh, dude.
Lefidium is a ridiculously rare material packed with
an Okay, Papa.
It is the key ingredient to the success behind the robots in RoboCorp Inc.
Okay.
Its energy is measured in consciousness, and even just a little bit of the stuff could do wonders for artificial intelligence.
Chess, business degree, and taxes.
Despite all his efforts, Sam ends up working for the first time in his life. At least he's alive. Sam's job is ridiculously simple. He has to pull the lever so a chunk of Lefidium comes down.
Where is it something?
Is it pulsed by a lever?
I don't see a lever. Is it?
Then he has to put the required amount of Lefidium in a robot's slot.
Dude, your dad couldn't have picked a worse day to make you work with this stuff. I guess we'll be back in hell in no time.
Sam's vision is blurrier than a Norwegian teenager at a wedding. He decides to blame.
Friggin' skateboard. Aye, let's see here. Yeah! Relax my body. Relax my knees. What I be doing wrong, yo?
Sam figures out how to open an automatic door. Impressive, Sam.
Oh, God. Aw, oh, son of a bitch. Okay.
Gonna do a kickflip now. Friggin' skateboard. Alright, let's see. Yeah! Relax my body. Bend in my knees.
Even that task gets too hard for Sam. God. He drops the incredibly toxic material.
Quick move.
Yeah. Gonna do a kickflip now.
Speedrun this. Right, okay.
Let's see. Yeah.
I don't want
to make the spin more time with you. Yeah, I know. Walk one more so we can. Yeah!
Ow.
Gonna do a kickflip now.
Blink, Sam, hey, blink!
Break skateboard.
Oh, oh, oh.
Yeah.
Sam decides to drink some water, because why not? Blink, Sam, blink!
Back here, open it again. No, we're gonna wait. Now.
Like, we'll go over there and press the button.
Oh, okay, I get what you're saying.
And that way, whenever we go there, it'll be done.
That makes sense.
That's my body.
Yeah, boy. Oh, we're gonna get two. It's okay. We know what to do.
Blink.
What's your leg? Never mind,
to do a kickflip now. Nah! Friggin' skateboard. Alright, let's see. Yeah! That's my body. And my knees. Yo, Sam! I can totally kickflip over that box.
Death says, having never actually landed a kickflip in his entire existence.
Yeah!
Looks safe. They're gonna take over the
robot. Death manages to spill Lephidium all over every robot in the basement.
No! Oh no! No! Sam! What are we gonna do, yo?
Every robot in the basement gets too conscious and escapes. Sam has to get out of work ASAP, and this time with a good excuse.
Don't you see, you doorknob? I was directly involved in waking those things to life. If they hurt anyone, I will be in 10 types of feces.
Sam decides to take a last sip of water before his demise. The electronic door is on lockdown mode. Sam comes to terms with his death and gives up.
No. You can't die now, dude.
The electronic door is on lockdown mode. Sam comes to terms with his death and gives up.
No. You can't die now, dude.
Oh, I know what to do.
Have water on it?
Yeah.
So I thought too. Press Y.
Oh.
And hold it in your mouth.
But wait, it looks like Sam has a plan.
That's the fun thing.
Damn it. Oh, I forgot I need to breathe out. Spit water.
Yeah.
It's your leg.
Sam, blink!
Shit. Uh-oh. Are we going to the door?
Incredible! Sam short-circuits the door! He will live to breathe manually another day.
Gosh darn it, you be...
Blink, Sam! Blink!
We do have to stop them. Yeah, that be what I be talking about, dude.
We are in deep feces, fellas. Someone exposed the robots to too much Lephidium, and now they are all conscious. They are headed straight for Mushroom Orphanage. Population, 300 lovely kids.
All the robots that became conscious were produced in the last 10 years. That means they have a large arsenal of functions, but are fragile as hell. We will have to use an old and sturdy manual robot to be able to take them down. It is controlled manually.
But gosh darn it, Johnson! None of us have done anything manually for years!
Oh, I still do things manually sometimes. Maybe I could... Yeah...
Just died already.
Okay. Told you she was due in a few hours.
Do we have any volunteers at all for this task?
It is not that I believe in you, son, but I've never seen you actually do anything on your own before. So, at this point, I just want to see what happens.
I can't see
that. Relax, bro. You ain't on your own.
Yeah, we are. He's gonna be there to yell at us. Yeah, right?
Yo, yo, yo! We need to blow up those robots before they hurt somebody.
Old Death is pointing the way. Sam, don't stop to ask why.
Oh, what the feces! Shoot at that door, yo! Shoot it 2 more times, bro! Your gun kind of sucks.
Sam turns that door into toothpicks. He's packing heat.
Oh, for feces sake, another door. Just use your missiles this time.
Sam blasts through the door. He's done messing around.
Gosh darn it, that be a door we can't blow through. Throw me behind it so I can open it up.
That's you. Yeah. But this is Lost Offer, I'm clicking it.
He walks on backwards. A tactical retreat.
There we go.
Hi. I'd be ready, but be careful.
He hurls Death without blinking.
Breathe.
Only amigo. He has to breathe manually while his friend is gone.
Oh, okay. He'll breathe for me until he's gone.
He rejoins his day-long friend. It's a touching reunion.
Oh, feces.
Can't get too close to those things. They get edgy.
Oh, watch your battery in this.
Oh, yes, a shield. Okay. Yeah. That's it now.
All right, dude. Good to go.
Go.
Sam takes out the first robot like he's taking out the trash.
Running
fella. Runner bots are sharp like a straight razor. Gotta pop them before they come too close. He pops them good.
We got this. We're still going good.
He encounters one of them old blue bots. Gotta chuck old Death out.
I'm not sure to chuck it. Yeah, but we're sitting ducks.
Yeah.
stand up.
He shoots. He misses.
Okay.
What if I just...
Okay, that was awful. Breathe.
Sam feels horrible for what he did, so he upchucks a little bit and feels a lot better. Big old fella pops up in front of Sam.
Drive back up.
Heat busts him up like he's getting paid for it. Yeah. Paid in pain.
Yo, I think I fixed it for you, Sammy.
Rounds at Tony's Cafe, like the good old days.
I caught you. You blew it up. You are a douchebag.
Robot is so much more complicated.
Yeah.
It's hard. You know what would be cool if you threw cars around.
That's the bullet.
He shoots. Misses.
Can we actually go back to grab that car? I don't know, I was wondering. It wants us to throw death, but it says.
I changed my
mind. Breathe.
Need no problem that don't need no fixing.
Let's try going back and fix that car.
Alright, dude. Good to go.
Picks up a car, uses it as a shield. Sam's suit shuts down. He needs to be more careful.
Yeah, me too. I was literally getting ready to release him for a while.
Yo, I think I fixed it, Sammy.
Is it back again? Oh. I don't think so. A little more? I don't think so. That's not what I see.
Thank you.
Oh, God. That was horrible.
Sam feels horrible for what he did. Throws up a little to feel better.
I don't know what that does. What? Like throwing up? Makes you feel better, I guess.
I changed my mind. Oh, God, that was horrible.
End of the trail, and the orphanage is still standing. Maybe a good day after all.
This day has to be over.
Dead kids. Oh, we be lucky.
But then the wind turns. There's one last robot needing to be taken care of. The maid bot.
Oh, feces, dude. Hold on to your flappy rooster.
Gotta watch out for them there missiles. Good old mines start ticking down. Sam gotta think fast.
Backwards.
He shoots. He misses.
Yeah. You got her good, dude. Oh, yeah.
The maid bot flies off. Starts dropping presents.
About. Oh, yeah. Yes. Oh, you got a good move.
Oh, yeah. Or, no.
Jeez, dude. Focus.
Yeah.
Finish her off, dude. Do it.
Oh no. Good. What do we do?
Oh.
Yeah.
This is the first time he said the bad word.
300 orphans go to heaven, which is a totally nice place, by the way. But death, he caused Satan at least 300 shreds of life.
Snap.
He ain't gonna be happy. And Sam, well, he's got a lot on his mind right about now. I don't know what came over me. Anyway, let's continue the story, shall we?
That's not the end?
No. Oh, feces! I have to disappear forever before he finds me. Just got to do one thing first.
Death has risked a meeting with the one he's trying to avoid for one simple item. The Skatemate 3000! Super easy to do kickflips with!
Oh, I'll be so close! I can almost taste the kickflips!
But then he arrives. The Angel of Darkness. The Evil Spirit! Mephistopheles! Lucifer! The King of Hell! Beelzebub! Satan!
Bum, bum, bum. Looking good, T Dog. Goat.
I wasn't.
It's actually what it's called, that he says.
What you be up to, bro?
Oh.
You know.
Satan things. Busy, busy, busy. Like a fly.
That's a. Yep. Good one.
So. I hear you killed 300 hairless apes.
Killed, I did. I was passing by while it happened, yes, but...
And they were too young to sin. So, they aren't even coming to hell.
I can pay you back. I have 300 shreds.
And where did you get 300 shreds, if you didn't steal them from me?
Weekend jobs.
You are in deep feces.
Feces. Feces all over, guys, just feces. What's this game rated?
Meanwhile, Sam is trying to pull himself out of deep feces. There are only a few hours left to his curse.
You must stay alive. Olives. We're just close, guys. We just gotta stay alive until. Uh oh. I'll do some coffee. Keep forgetting to move. Damn. Alright, get ready. I don't know. I just had a feeling that our back was going to break. I did too. This happened every time we got upstairs.
I know, that's why I was like, I just had a feeling.
Cool.
right as Sam is about to go to bed, she arrives.
No, war.
Can you believe that idiot? He went ahead and got himself thrown in hell jail, so now I have to be both death and war. That's double shifts and no extra pay. Anyway, it says here that you were supposed to die almost 24 hours ago.
Sam tries to say something along the lines of, no, no, please don't, this is no fun, this is no fun. But his lack of competence in the art of speaking manually only results in this happening.
You were nowhere close. Yeah, she didn't get a chance. Oh, he didn't give you a chance, you just went over?
I said, no, I was about to press O.
Once again, and... Sam is in hell.
Come on, I'm supposed to take you to the gate.
Gosh damn it.
Away from that bitch.
Get away!
Can't catch me.
That sucks.
Why, hello there, dear sir. Let's see if we can find a job for you. You get to be, ooh, the son of the CEO of a huge company. You get your own office, and you get to play Flappy Rooster all day. That will be all your shreds, dear sir. Sam remembers that he has none left. Oh, no shreds.
God damn, thanks, Kate. Oh, I'm terribly sorry, sir, but this means
you have to go to hell jail. Guards! Have a nice day.
Oh, no shreds, eh? Well, it can happen to the best of us, mate. Let's take you to hell jail then, shall we? Such fun.
Take all your concerns up with upper management. What's your favorite movie, mate? Mine is It's a Wonderful Life.
There you go, mate. Hope you will have a good time.
Well, nice.
Take all concerns up with upper management.
And there he is.
Get that guy.
Yo, 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 Sam. Oh, you came to save me. Oh, you truly be a bro, bro. So, what be the plan? Dude, that be hardcore. But I suppose that be the only way. Aye, when the god comes back, I'll rip him out.
It's like South Park all over.
But you inside. You should be able to control him with That's your manual up. Powers. Here he comes.
Do you like strawberry or chocolate cupcakes, mate? I brought them both just in case. Whoa!
Heck yeah, it worked, bro. All right, crush these bombs and then get your butt to the spot where we met for the first time. Be getting out of here, yo.
As the still warm insides of the guard squeeze against Sam's skin, he thinks about how lucky he is to be rich, so he can pay for all the hours of therapy after this.
I'm terribly sorry, sir, but I have to take you.
Sam violently kills a guard. He'll just be reborn as a demon anyway. Of course, Sam doesn't know that. As Sam recovers, so does his foe.
Demons.
Oh wait, I am.
Best here, sir. You are not being there. Can't we all just be friends here, sir?
What?
Terribly
sore. Oh,
as Sam recovers, so does his foe.
I start putting that
like,
really fast.
You know, Sam, it isn't that hard.
I'm terribly sorry, sir.
Fuck.
Harry, Sam! It isn't Black. That hard! As Sam recovers,
we have to hold it, yeah. Same time.
How about we get back to China and watch a code?
And back. Hold.
Sam slays another guard. Hold. Crazy. Desperate.
You're not being very nice,
hold right it. Now. It's because we got deflected.
How about we get you back to jail and watch a cozy movie?
And there goes another one.
So hard.
Ah.
I'm terribly sorry, servant. I have to take you back to China. Can't we all just be friends?
If this goes on for a while, let's just see what happens.
Can't we all just be friends here, sir? You are not my
friend.
As sun recovers, so does its foe.
I'm underwear right
now. I'm terribly sorry, sir, but I have to take you back to China.
As Sam recovers,
rapping?
So
does
his I'm terribly sorry, sir. I have to take you back to jail.
God damn it, I was
mean. Sam recovers, so does his foe.
Demon soda is the best, sir.
Sam needs to parry those swings if he wants to make it.
Being very nice right now, dear sir.
Why is it?
So does his foe.
Delicious. You're not being very nice. How about we get you back to jail? Can't we all just be friends, dear
what?
Sir?
Yeah.
All those fencing classes for nothing.
I have to take you back to jail.
As Sam recovers, so does his foe.
You're not being very nice right now, dear sir. How about we get you back to jail and watch a cozy movie together, sir?
You made it!
He just walks.
Alright, let me just open up a portal. Oh, snap.
Silly, hairless.
Oh, snap.
I'll make your pain beyond imaginable.
Time to mention those concern-related concerns, Sam.
Shit. Oh, this is me, sorry. Damn it, that was me. Oh. Yeah. Up again. Day. Oh. Yeah. Okay. What? What?
Oh, I know what you're doing.
What do you guys that mean to like, we can purposely mess up and do that? Oh, okay. Okay, alright. Then use his wings. Alright. Yeah. We were actually working together. It worked because the doctor just put our swords up right there. Okay. Flag you. That flag.
I.
You can't.
God damn it.
He understood that.
In and out of hell as you please, ape.
I will.
You can't just stroll in and out of hell as you please, ape.
You gotta attack him.
You can't just stroll in and out of hell as you please, ape.
God damn it.
You can't just stroll in and out of hell as you please. You can't just
shut up.
In and out of hell as you please, ape.
Yes.
You can't just stroll in and out of hell as you please,
yep.
Ape.
Flag. No, flag! That was me.
You can't just. just stroll in and out of hell as you please.
Like boss
ape.
Like him. No, this is to get up. That's why I said get up before that. That way, that would do anything.
You can't just.
I don't think so, because it's an overhead attack. But it should still hit us. That was you.
Ape.
Because it's an overhead attack.
Just stroll in and out of hell as you please.
Boss.
Ape.
So if you're the one that goes down, I'm the one that has to double click, right? The leg. Because if you go down, yeah, I'm the one that has to double click. Okay. Ah, it was my fault. I fucking held it and I let go. Because I was like, why didn't it go? So I went to let go and to do it again. That's my fault.
You can't just stroll in and out of hell as you please.
My fault.
Ape.
I did it again! Hold it. Because, like, I held it. I don't know if it's because I'm waiting for you or if it's just because we haven't gone yet, you know what I mean?
As you please, ape.
I fucked that up. Okay.
You
can't. My fault. Damn it!
Okay. Just stroll in and out of hell as you please, ape.
Ah, it's okay. Now we know how to get there. It's cool.
Just stroll in and out of hell as you please, ape.
Oh, it's a hit before he does that.
Oh, okay.
Fuck, that was me. I was trying to swing also. Hit him. Oh, he's gonna fall. Yeah. Okay. Get up. Fall. Get up. Block. Oh.
It goes like.
Yeah, I know. It's slow and fast. I know. I thought you were gonna get it too. Okay. That was so close.
Eclipse though.
This is all that. What you did? You release?
No.
What's your block? Oh. That's what I was thinking. The same thing. That was me. I blocked. Okay. And this took forever. No. Okay. Oh. yeah, that was me. I forgot to get up. I just tried to block. Damn it. Yeah, boy.
Oh, I have to blow his sword. Okay, that makes sense.
Just blow it real good, man. Drop. No, oh, I was clicking the.
Instead of the other one, you're clicking the hit button.
Yeah. Okay. Hit him. What?
I was like, oh, I got cocky. I was like, maybe we can finish this quickly.
I'm going to crush.
Brand new. It's good. I'm just saying it was my mom. Yeah. It's cool. It's cool. Oh, that was me. That was my fault. I didn't realize it was,
He wants a kiss.
Give me a...
Give me a kiss!
Here's... Just trying to make sure that my, because at 2 hours my thing like, doesn't work, so I'm gonna make sure that. Almost. Kickflip, dog! Oh!
Holy feces! Did Death just do a kickflip?
As Satan is distracted, Sam grabs the opportunity and grabs Satan's sword.
How did he do that? I've been.
Ouch! What the feces, dude? Oh, sorry, dude. No offense, but you were being kind of a douche.
Take me to a gosh darn hell hospital.
Oh, okay, dude.
To a gosh darn hell hospital.
Oh, thanks for everything, Sammy. Of course you get to live again. I will even grant you one final wish.
Sam looks up to the sky and wishes that the 300 orphans came back to life, safe and sound. Not that heaven is a bad place to be.
But that's 300 orphans and 300 shreds. I've been saving up for an eternity. Oh, fine.
And so Sam gets resurrected for the last time.
I bet that's pissed.
Our story ends in the middle of last Wednesday, where a sort of hopeful young man named Sam is about to make amends with his girlfriend.
Whoa, you showed up on time for once.
How cute! Cat sweater. Good job, Sans. Yeah. That was actually really tough.
Yeah, it was fun though, wasn't it?
That was really fun.
Ah, look at him. Aha.
It's all because that he did that kickflip.
Did it when I did
before. Oh, and she said that Satan was impressed by death. So he raised death and more salary by mind-boggling 55%. Golden gun over there. Four horsemen of the apocalypse finally got 2 weeks of paid vacation.
They got pants. They got pants.
Texas Tuesday, reality TV, and bad fan fiction filled in for them. That is okay. Sam Sr. earned a fortune from the publicity of 300 orphans getting resurrected in front of his company. Hope he used it well. The demons, slayed by Slam, are totally fine. They aren't even mad. They were really nice demons. I like they were mad. They
brought them cupcakes.
Oh,
strawberry cupcakes.
Oh, that's all. Okay. Good game. I like that. That's fun. It's really fun. I totally recommend it. Totally recommend it. If you guys have not played this game, look it up. It was great. It was lots of fun. I can't imagine trying to play that by yourself. Like controlling everything, like breathing. I mean, I don't know, there's certain things that would be easier, like breathing and stuff, because it's X and B, that's really easy. I don't know, some parts of that would be really easy, and other parts, like remembering to do everything, I think that's gonna be the hard part. Like, because you have so much to do, but like as of doing everything, it would be really easy. Because maybe you blink, like, you know when you're gonna blink, you don't have to worry about like falling down as much, because you're the one in control of this walking and you know when to stop and stuff. But I don't know, in other parts, like remembering the blank and stuff. But it's fine, the one that I kept almost forgetting.
PS was still stinging.
Oh, is that what it said to me? PS was still stinging. How did the game come out? It did not help them at all to finish the game. Bravo. Again, guys, Emmanuel Samuel, coming to this. We're going to do some of this more often, doing these co-op games. I have a lot of fun doing them. So, I was really trying to talk until the interview credits, you know, just to be like an, hey, you know, check the game out, here's all the people who did it, yeah. But it's taking a little longer. So, hope you guys enjoyed this video. If you haven't already, like, subscribe, and even if you have subscribed, make sure to click the bell so you get notified when we have new and more videos. This is GingaDude15 and KyleBrennan4544, and this is Salt Studios, and we are signing off. Oh, just kidding.
Seven. Oh, man, I made it!
Dude,
I was just kidding.
The end. Thank God! Are you kidding me? If you had any idea how long this process took, you're sitting there just playing the game whenever you damn well feel like it. Speedrunner, my a- You couldn't speedrun a...
I don't even know what I'd use as a simile for that, because it's stupid. Speed running, I don't even know what that is. This isn't even my normal speaking voice. I'm an American and I'm doing a British accent in this recording studio. I don't want to do it anymore. I've had it. I don't want to talk like this. Do you know how difficult that is? I'm going home. Jory, I'm out of here. Goodbye.
That's the guy from Kids Next Door's father.
Oh, that is? That was awesome. I think it was. It did sound like that. Dr. Jory, we love and miss you. That was funny. Man, I was just kidding. Not what I thought he meant when he said smack and shaman. Yeah. Alright, again, guys, like I said, this is GingaDude15 and KyleBrennan4545 at Assault Studios signing off.